and JYP. I'm Master Rai, one hell of a beast, and here with me now is...
Nomad, I came back from the dead, and we are here for the grand finals. This is Indonesia versus Malaysia.
Now we're going to be starting up the knife round.
Yes, and the stabby McStab stab is about to happen here. Yeah. So while the stabbing is happening, who's your pick here for the grand finals?
Honestly, my pick is JYP, or not really. Actually, it should be Reka Esports because I'm a fan of how Bentet plays.
Uh-huh.
But realistically looking, you know, in this tournament, X-Crit has been so far behind in terms of performance as an opera, and he has been, well, you know, I don't want to sugarcoat it, or, you know, I don't want to say sound too bad, but he has been carried by his other teammates because I haven't seen him have too much impact with that opping.
Yeah, I've been seeing his opping skills lately, and most of his shots were not connecting at all, and that is going to hamper his performance. So I guess he's the person that we need to look forward to step up in this game. And aside from that, we have Bentet and Kaze. From both teams, they are the highest rated players throughout this tournament. Well, for me, I'm just leaning towards Reka Esports at this point. And this is a best of three for the grand finals of
Southeast Asian qualifiers for the Zen League. Of course, whoever wins this Shootout Season 3 will have a spot to fight for that 100K?
100,000 Australian dollars.
Prize pool.
Yeah. And the bomb has now been planted here at A, and the heat is on to Reka to go ahead and go for the retakes, and they are slowly flooding in. Just a soul straggler in the behind, and Bentet actually takes the first kill at Celeste. Make that two kills. X-Crit and Bentet are racking up the kills here. Akup is going to try to see if he can go and save the bomb, but it's not going to happen. The bomb has been defused, and Reka Esports takes the first round. And this is going to be a guaranteed three rounds for Reka Esports, considering the fact that they will be able to buy up the SMGs or the rifles if they so wish.
Yes, and again, guys, we do like to remind you that we already optimize the stream as much as we can. I guess, you try to optimize as much as we can, and on our side, it is looking smooth, so we don't know what's happening anymore. But yeah, so Reka Esports were able to get a pretty clean round, only losing one, and now they're going to be stacking up with two rifles and the three SMGs, so I really like this. I mean, you don't just overcommit to either all rifles or all SMGs, just because you don't want to... allow any anti-ecos to actually happen whenever, like, JYP decides to go for the, for that force buy. You kind of want some firepower with the rifles in your hands.
Exactly, and if you drop the rifles, that is going to suck. I mean, that's already going to give JYP the advantage if they go for the eco rounds, they get your rifles. That's going to significantly give them a boost to take back the game and possibly tie it up in the second round. And that's what they, you know, that's what they need to go against. And hold that thought, Frost, Missy, and Amen going in for the trade kills there. And I think this bomb is now slowly going to be, but they haven't spotted the bomb yet, Reka Esports. It's just pretty passive going all throughout for everyone.
I think they already did, because Amen actually had the bomb in his hands, and he did get the kill there. So right now, Reka Esports... at least shifting their position accordingly here, and they do have X-Crit right at the side himself, and then Bentet is just here near middle for that fast rotation, possibly. Mm-hmm. A gonna get spotted out. Super Sis does take a little bit of damage, but now the bomb will be forced into the B site. X-Crit gonna be the line of defense here, but he immediately fails, and that bomb will be planted for JYP.
And that's gonna be a guaranteed money for them. This is now a 2v3 situation. The time is now ticking for Reka Esports to go in for the retake, and the retake is slowly happening right now. Molotov's getting thrown there, and the entry will happen soon. Rizzo takes out the first kill, and Bentet finishes everything up. It's now 2-0 in favor of Reka Esports.
And that bomb will get defused, so JYP accelerating the buy run a little bit faster here. Just a little bit for our viewers. But yeah, so JYP will be able to accelerate their buy round, and from the looks of their money, it looks like they'll be able to at least just get AKs all across the board. Or if they do wish, maybe put Kaze or Celeste immediately on a glass cannon op. Not really sure, but
oh, yeah. There you go. The glass cannon op is already there, and the timeout has been paused for A-Man to connect, and he has already connected.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Like, he just goes for that that AWP, because he has been actually watching him the previous rounds or the previous matches from yesterday and the day before that.
Mm-hmm.
He has been actually prevalent with getting these aggressive op kills, and that's just allowing JYP for, you know, easier access into the sites.
Yeah, and JYP going for, you know, Kaze going for the glass cannon AWP. Let's see if it's gonna pay off for him. He hasn't had any single frags yet. Their team is significantly down in the economy, so to speak. They're able to go for the full buy. Celeste, smarter decision would actually be to just go for the scout so that he can actually buy utilities or maybe even an armor. Kevlar with a helmet, that would have helped a lot, considering the fact that Rekka Esports actually has the M4s, the FAMASs, and the UMP, which all of them will not be a one-hit headshot. It's only the AWP from Excurate that is the number one problem for them in terms of getting killed instantly.
Yes. So now we can see Frostmist, they actually force or pushing very forward in low and mid with the help for that smoke, so he's gonna have at least a forward position to maybe hear a lot of the footsteps from JYP if they decide to actually go and push onto the A site. Bomb still yet at the main garage, but nothing gets to happen. There's pretty slow round, just trying to get as much information as possible and trying to clear out every single corner. Acap, I think he knows something's up right there in mid. He does have an angle, but it's Celeste who should be their entry fragger with that op. He's looking for someone, but not just yet.
Yeah, everybody's playing very passively here. Everybody's waiting for an opening, and Celeste actually spots out somebody there at highway, but it's not gonna connect, and he instantly gets taken down by Frost Misty. Immediately, JYP is falling down like a sack of potatoes. It's now down to a 5v3 situation. The take here is not gonna happen because JYP is pretty scattered all across the map, and Anna actually takes down Benta right there. A 3v4 situation, they are pretty scattered. What's your take on this?
A-Man's gonna be flashing himself in onto the A site, but Excrit is there to defend. Ana, the only one left standing, but he's all the way through A, and he has to go through the bushels of Rekka Esports there. He gets found out by SuperSys and Rekka Esports on their first trial. The gunner of JYP, they still come out on top. My thoughts on that, it just looked like JYP were kind of slow. They try to actually do some pop flashes into mid and allow Celeste to maybe get a pick. He actually misses the first shot, and of course, you know, Rekka Esports with that forward position paying off for Frost Misty. He finds Celeste, and JYP, they kind of lose a little bit of hope as their, you know, upstart player is taken to the grave.
Alright, and now JYP is opting for a more aggressive approach here on A side. They're just stacking up onto A main and at Squeaky, just waiting for the smoke to clear, and that is when they're coming in. They have P250s, they have Tech-9s, and a couple of flashes that would be helpful in the take, and here is what's gonna happen. They are all inside now, but they haven't spotted Rizzo yet. Rizzo gonna go ahead and take down two people and make that, is that a three? No, it's not gonna be a three, and he gets taken down by PZ Kid, and that was a fast round by Rekka Esports.
Yeah, I mean, nothing much to it. They just wanted to go for the push. They didn't spot Rizzo right at the side there of Quad.
You always need to check every single corner.
Yeah, but to be fair, Rizzo as well did not actually spray his bullet through the flash, and actually paid well for him. 50-50
yeah.
Chance of survival, and he did, so he was able to solidify the defense on the A side.
Exactly. Also, for those of you asking, Anna is Sever and Celeste is Kaze. Excurate getting the op kill onto PZ Kid, and it might have boosted his momentum there. Finally getting the op kills, he might be able to connect every single shot from here on out. And it's quickly down to a 5v3 situation. Nothing much is happening here, and Bentet, he is leading the scoreboard for everyone, getting 8 kills slowly, then followed by Excurate.
Yeah, Excurate looking to actually start off strong today. Let's see if he's going to be consistent through this best of three. This is, of course, the finals match. They have to make or break this one. Rekka Esports, again, not in dire straits in terms of performance, but they're not overall consistent. Some of them are, but again, X-Grit still looking for his groove, but maybe he just found it. Now, Celeste is the one here who should be starting it off, but of course, T-side, this may get a little bit difficult for him, but
ooh, nice
he finds the one onto X-Grit. That's great entry frag there for the B-side. He's smashed off a little bit here, but it still has the angle right up on top of Heaven. And maybe Rekka Esports will try to go into this one, but they respect the AWP skills of here of Celeste. You don't want to go overly aggressive. Frost Misty.
That Molotov is actually going to force Frost Misty outside. He doesn't know where Celeste is. And Celeste is with, does have the Glass Cannon AWP, and he immediately gets taken down by Frost Misty. 4-0 now, and still in favor of Rekka Esports. JYP needs to find an answer to this.
Yeah, JYP starting to lose the round here.
And yeah, JYP is able to go for a partial buy. It's not everyone that has a utility, but it will do. They just need to make proper use of your utilities. Make sure every pop flash counts, every smoke covers the essentials, basically. And this is looking, starting to look like an A take again, once again from JYP. Rekka Esports hasn't seen anything. They're spread out pretty evenly here, pretty standard.
Oh, I like this from Rousseau. Whenever I see Rekka Esports actually go in cash, they always have Rousseau here on top, but now
they know. They've learned their lesson. Yeah. JYP now cleaning up the floor, but it's now down to a 3v1 situation. It's just A-Man on his own. He's going to force a bomb blaster that his team can have the money. And there you go. He finally has the money. The defuse is now coming in for Rekka Esports. JYP is...
JYP had the right mindset there. They knew that something was up from Rekka Esports, that Rousseau really likes to go for that CT boost on A site whenever Rekka Esports start to snowball, you know, in terms of the money. JYP clearing out properly, but individual player skills coming out from Bentet, his performance was on point, and he got like a 3k on that. Actually, yeah, 3k. So he was able to just chip them down all and save it for Rekka Esports.
Yeah. For those of you asking, this is the first map, so nobody won yet, so to speak. And no, I will not be saying Tokyo Sandblaster. That's Tokyo Sandblaster. What were we saying on the first game? Zoomer Banger. But yeah, Benta takes down Anna there. Quickly down to a 5v4 situation. JYP is losing. They're kind of losing their focus here. They've been slowly getting outfragged by Rekka Esports and the entry frag.
This is why I like Bentet as a player. You see there, he just knows the angles of how to actually, where to spray, and he even tags ACAP down to 48 as he was like one brush of a bullet to death. But of course, that's just my seeing little itsy bits of player performance. Now JYP with one man down and not a lot of utility to work with. They're actually stacking up onto upper mid here, but Super Sis does have the angle, so he'll know if they actually rush in through that area. I haven't actually seen JYP go for that triple smoke mid control, which is not a bad play here to actually get some, you know, some control of this mid side.
Yeah, and as soon as you get the
man down and not a lot of utility to work with, they're actually stacking up onto upper mid here, but Super Sis does have the angle, so he'll know if they actually rush in through that area. I haven't actually seen JYP go for that triple smoke mid control, which is not a bad play here to actually get some, you know, some control of this mid side.
Yeah, and as soon as you get the mid control, you have control of majority of the map. And Super Sis takes down ACAP, and he tries to take Celeste through the smoke and Squeaky, but it's not going to connect, and the bomb plant is going to be planted by A-Man. It's now down to a 3v3 situation. The time is now ticking for Rekka Esports. And the retake is now happening. Flashes and smokes are now coming in. Well, just flashes coming in from Rekka Esports. And they are now going to try to see if they can take the side again. And Benton X-Grit, it's now down to a 1v1 situation. AWP versus AK-47. X-Grit versus Celeste. Celeste has no idea where X-Grit is. The defuse is now happening. Celeste thinks it's a fake. Wow.
And
what happened there?
X-Grit just got it. Wow.
I mean, I mean, you know, at the first sign of a defuse, at least you know it's a fake, but you know, you should at least try to peek it, you know?
Well,
you wouldn't know it. I mean, in that situation, he probably thought that he was faking, but joke's on him.
Pro's never fake. I mean, our chat is saying it already.
What? Yeah. Yes, pros don't fake. Exactly.
But if you think about it, he actually did.
He faked a fake. Oh.
Yeah. Oh, he faked a fake. That's. Yeah, actually, that's not a bad way of putting it.
He faked a fake. Wow, that's a new term. Put it on the dictionary. Nomad and Azeroth. But yeah, pretty dull moment so far. JYP is still looking for openings, and this is a pretty hard stack on A for Rekka Esports. JYP hasn't tried taking B actually as a team. They just resorted to going to B when they're down two people. Benta takes down that cap. It's now down to a 5v4 situation. Make that a 5v3 situation as Xcurrent is doing work with that AWP. Celeste finally takes down Rizzo. And it's down to a 2v1 situation. A-Man once again falls down. 8-0 in favor of Rekka Esports.
That wasn't a really good execution from JYP. If you checked how they actually approached the site, it looked like they just allowed people from Highway to push up. And then waited for, 3 seconds before they pushed in from A-Main as well as Squeaky. And that doesn't work, because what just happens there is Rekka Esports, all they have to do is focus on the one entry point, counter that out, and, well, JYP lose two members for no exchange at all and not even any control of the A site.
Mm. And JYP actually needs to switch things up. They were playing pretty passive. Right now, they need to play a bit more aggressive. Catch Rekka Esports off guard.
Yeah.
I mean, they haven't tried taking B as an entire team. So that may be a viable strategy for them. Well, Rekka Esports has been stacking A for most of the rounds anyway.
That's also true. Actually, I kind of want to see first... hang on. Rekka Esports were the team who actually picked Cash, so... Yeah, this is their map. This is the map that they've chose for themselves, and it's working out wonders for them. And JYP, I don't think they're comfortable with this one, so it could also be the reason why they're kind of faltering here as a team.
Yeah, this may not be their best map. I mean, who knows? Our next map, JYP might be able to bounce back and force a reverse sweep, but. You know, this is Counter-Strike. Anything can happen here.
Anything can happen, indeed. JYP, again, like I said, they're in dire straits. 7 rounds straight is what they're looking for. You know, to go to that second half with a close scoreline against Rekka Esports. But now, anything goes. They have to at least get something off the on the board here for themselves. Mm-hmm. But they're gonna be on only the Tech-9s and even that one P250, so I don't know. This is gonna be a full rush.
Look at the map, though. This is pretty cheesy.
Oh, it actually is. And it could also work because they are rushing in.
It could work. The rotation is forced by JYP, and Rekka Esports is now slowly doing work. They know that the bomb is not at A. At B, I mean, I'm sorry. It's just down to Akap to hold down the site against 4 guys with M4s and armors versus a Tech-9. That's a tall order, but we'll see if it's going to happen. Akap takes down Rizzo. Benta is going to be the next one to follow, but he quickly goes down. And this is going to be a defuse by Rekka Esports.
I think the reason why Rekka Esports actually full rotated there because it's B site. If you think about it, B side is much more is much tighter than the A side. So if they rush in as a whole 5-man unit, or you know, if they fake and just have like 4 people, having Rekka Esports rotate from all angles will allow them for an easy defense. But vice versa, if it's actually on A site, even if you just leave 3 people to defend there, it's still gonna be
still pretty open. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's pretty open because they still have a lot of angles to cover, and the angles that they're covering are, you know, they're basically funneled in. As soon as the T side goes into A, that's where they have the problems. But if they're just outside of the side and just going in, CT's already have the defense there.
Sure enough. So Force with that a bomb plant. Oh, the bomb is being dropped already, and Rousseau finding the one that's gonna be A-man. Celeste is really flashed in. He misses the opportunity there when he was able to get away from the grasp of danger. Two Molotovs being thrown out. And here comes Ana trying to boost or force himself in, maybe to at least flank from that squeaky door, but Bentet falls through him and he will get taken down as well. And PZ Kid here at mid.
PZ Kid.
Oh, he was already spotted by Excurit.
Excurit takes down PZ Kid. It's just Celeste on his own. He needs to save that AWP. He loves his AWP so much.
He can't though. I mean, it's 5v1. He's gonna get.
Yeah, he's quickly gonna get surrounded, and he misses the shot.
And Brekka Esports with a clean round in this one. Nobody died at all.
And this may be a clean game for Brekka Esports. Depending if JYP will be able to bounce back and actually find their, find their mojo, so to speak. And JYP is opting to go for the Force Bites there.
Actually not Force Bites, they have so much money because of that blue shell effect.
Yeah, just enough for the AKs, armors, and the utilities. But you know, if it were me, I'd still go for an eco buy, just buy SMGs and hope for the best. You know, well that's me. That's why I'm stuck in.
Oh, Russell likes to actually do this as well. Yeah, he's gonna go through here and then boost himself up onto. Oh wait, oh, that's not for speed. He fights it up.
Lots of fires coming his way.
Yeah. Well, he didn't get lucky there. There was the wall blocking his spray.
And that, I mean, if you're trying to be cheesy, at least make sure that you're hiding in the behind smoke, right? But yeah, JYP is still waiting for. JYP is still waiting for an opening here. They actually have the man advantage. But their health is actually not extremely low, but a couple of shots from their M4s would actually take them out. Everybody's playing patient. Bentet actually spots the head of PZ Kid right there.
Got a little bit lucky now. Bentet's gonna get a little bit overwhelmed, and here on the side, it's going to only be Super Sis with the defense. He has to at least delay them for his teammates to rotate, but that's not gonna be the case. Excurit, nice shot onto PZ Kid. That's gonna start it off for Rekka Esports with the rotation here for the retake, but it doesn't happen. Celeste is shutting him down in Frost Misty. I mean, Rekka Esports has so much money to work with, so I think just, you know, taking a couple of guns away from the hands of JYP would be the wiser choice, but he's not gonna be successful with that. So Rekka Esports finally losing the one round.
And yeah, JYP, this may be a significant boost for them. Like, they finally got a round in. Though it's kind of late, Rekka Esports is in one hell of a lead. The second half would be a different story because JYP, they played significantly better on the CT side of things in cash. So we'll see if that would change things up here. But yeah, at this point, JYP, they just need to make sure that every single move they make, it's swift and concise. They need to outpower Rekka Esports here.
Where's Excurit? Oh, I see.
Cheesy angle there.
Yeah, cheesy angle right outside of A main. Super Sis might actually be flooded here with JYP players mid.
Excurit actually takes out A man there. Quickly down to a 5v2 situation. Super Sis gets two frags. Now down to a 5v2 situation. PZ Kid and Celeste, they actually both have AWPs there.
Now Celeste peeking through. Squeaky gets the one man off, but now they're gonna be trying to catch off PZ Kid. He gets the one off shot as well. Double op on T.
Against a three-man rifle retake. That, I mean,
bomb still yet to get planted though.
Yeah, they still have time to get it planted on A, but the more time that you spend, the more time that Benta is going to rotate just like that. He takes down PZ Kid. It's just Celeste on its own, and the rest of Rekka Esports are now on the hunt for Celeste. And Celeste takes down Frost Misty. Down to a 2v1. He spots someone there at Highway, but he gets taken down by Super Sis. 11-1, still in favor of Recce Esports.
If anybody can actually get that clutch, it should have been Celeste, but not today. No joy for Celeste there.
I mean, this is the finals, and whoever wins will be flying to Australia to compete in the Zen League. So tensions are high here at this point. Everybody's pretty nervous. They just need to get rid of the jitters here. But yeah, JYP with a bit of unusual buy, a Galil, two AKs, an AWP, and just a Tech Knight for A-Man. They opted to go for the UMPs. That would have been a lot better, because a UMP, if used well like a rifle, it might do them good, actually. Because the UMP is pretty deadly and long range. You just need to know how to properly use it.
Still, I think Galil is a much more reasonable option. But JYP's looking to actually have more firepower if you look at it. But Rousseau again with the angles, they're not spotting him out at all. They don't check that. And they get punished for the 2K. And he's gonna go to the left, find the one, but A-Man able to get the one kill. But at the same time, he's in a 3v1 situation. He's gonna try to at least overwhelm the one guy. Left with a couple of bullets, jumps up, and Frost Misty finds him in the midst of it all. And that'll be Recce Esports winning this round 12-1.
And it's safe to say that Recce Esports will be able to close out the first half at least 14. Well, I mean, that's me. Because right now you're just going to work with three Tech Nines, two Glocks. I mean, you know.
It's nothing. They don't have anything at all. It's just going to be JYP, possibly a B split here, coming in from mid as well as B main.
Just like what I said, just rush in.
Bennett's going to be spotting that out. So the one who will be embracing them is Frost Misty, coming in from Checkers. He spots out three already and is going to look for the 4K. Actually, make that a 3K only. And 13-1. I mean, JYP have been forcing themselves too much. They don't really get the picks that they wanted. That one round that they got off of Recce Esports, that was the only round where Recce Esports looked to have actually lost their aim.
Yeah.
Yeah. If they don't lose their aim, JYP always lose the duel.
Yeah, at this point, JYP is looking like they don't have enough strategies on the T side here to actually successfully go for take. They've been playing pretty scattered, and X-Ray takes down Anna. They've been playing pretty scattered here. It's not the wisest decision in cash, because if you split up, you gotta make sure that you guys follow it through, you know. But yeah, quickly down to a 5v3 situation. This is going to be Recce Esports's app, basically.
And X-Ray finding PZK as he tries to re-peek through A main. And now, it's gonna be Celeste, or also known as Kaze,
yeah,
to maybe clutch it for his team. 5v1 situation. This is where, you know, the GOATs, the greatest of all times, are born, but that's not the time for Celeste to shine. And Recce Esports coming into the second half with a monumental lead, 14-1, only two more rounds, and it's over for game one.
Exactly. And I guess you could say that Recce is on fire. This is the flame of Recce.
Yeah. Sure. Well, their team logo is a dragon. Yeah, it looks like a dragon.
I think it is a dragon.
So yeah, it could be Flame of Recce.
Yeah. Second round, second half, things are gonna look different here. JYP is now on the defensive. Recce Esports is now dictating the momentum here. Seeing a couple of utilities there coming from X-Crit with the smokes and the flashes. Single defuse kit coming in from A-Man and a smoke.
Yeah, I don't really like it when T's actually just go into the side. Wait, hold that thought. PZ kid, so on point with this USP. Gets a couple already, but they've dropped the site. So it's gonna be X-Crit with the bomb down. PZK's gonna be charging in, hoping to maybe cancel it out to catch Recce Esports a little bit off guard, but that's not gonna be the case. And now PZK, man against the world. Well, not really, 3v3 situation, but
3v2, make it.
Yeah.
You know, Recce Esports has this, basically. Oh wait, they're actually down to a 2v1 situation. And yeah, Rekka Esports is now on match point. This is a fast game, and it's just one more round before Rekka Esports takes a first game.
Yeah. Rekka on fire. I think that sounds better than Flame of Rekka.
Flame of Rekka.
Or
I mean, if they
Rekka ablaze.
Sure. He actually did a dab after saying that. Oh my god. But yeah, thanks for correcting us there. It's a snake, not a dragon.
Reptile.
They're both reptiles, but yeah, hold that thought. Anna takes down Super Sis. Rizzo going in for the refrag there with the UMP. And Benta takes down PZ Kid. It's now down to a 4v3 situation. But Rekka Esports, they're actually pretty low. They could be get taken down there by the pistol buys that JYP has. Quickly down to a 2v3 situation. They can steal guns and actually make this work, but the bomb has now been planted. The time is now ticking. And JYP needs to find an answer. They need to go all in for this. A-Man gonna try to see if he can get for the D's. Go for the D's. He's not gonna happen. He misses his shot. It's just Akap on his own with a UMP. He takes down Bentet. He takes down X-Ray. It's now down to a 1v1 situation. Frost missing. Goes down!
And Akap able to clutch it with a 3k on the UMP. And he racks up 4 kills after that one. A-Man losing all the shots with the deal. But Akap was able to hold his hand and keep the dream alive for JYP.
And wow, the dream is still here. Rekka Esports is still in the lead, but JYP has one round. Is this going to be a comeback? What are your thoughts?
I don't think so. I really wanted to see that comeback happen too. You know, just because it's going to be entertaining to watch. And, you know, JYP does have the moxie to actually do it, but I feel like it's too far already.
You know, this is Counter-Strike. Anything can happen. You can go for the reverse sweeps if you want to. If you want to.
Well, we'll see. If you can.
If you can, yeah, that's the question there. I mean, of course, everybody wants to go for the reverse comebacks there. But yeah, Benta takes down Anna. It's now down to a 5. Oh, it's down to a 3v4 situation. JYP actually has the upper hand here with the bomb getting dropped on their side. JYP has rotated on to be keeping the guard, to keep the bomb safe. A-Man and Akap, they actually, wow, they clean up shop. They are starting to set up shop here. 15-3, JYP is slowly coming.
Yeah, but Rekka Esports, now this is their gun round. Bentet, no armor in this guy. Oh, never mind, there you go. He buys it now. But yeah, Rekka Esports will be on the rifles. Same for JYP, but at the same time, what can they do? Will they be able to actually win this one out? This is make or break for JYP. 12 straight rounds. This is still what they need to actually get here to force it into overtime and maybe take it from the hands of Rekka Esports. Mm-hmm. But you know what? We'll see. Rekka Esports are having a little bit of a difficult time to actually get this round or this game one finished already.
Akab is actually playing pretty aggressive there at A main. He knows something, so he goes for the re-smoke there. Just delaying the push from Rekka Esports. And at this point, they have no information aside from he's hearing a couple people outside A main.
Easy Kid with that scout, but he's not in a forward angle at all. Oh, they boost up Super Sis here, so they're gonna go for something a little bit cheeky.
A mid to A, maybe?
No, I mean, this is why you go for the mid control, because you can actually just rotate from either, you know, if you decide either A to B without having to sacrifice so much time for the rotation.
But look at this. They are going in for the B take. They are pretty stacked here at B. They now hear the vents breaking, and the assault is now on for Rekka Esports. JYP needs to defend this side perfectly. A-Man takes down Rizzo. Frost Missy takes down Celeste. Benta takes down PZ Kid. A-Man going in for the triple kill there. And it's just Frost Missy on his own. Gonna try to see if he can go for the retake, but it's not gonna happen. JYP gets another round. 15-4.
Man, A-Man was stapled on that B site. If he was taken down, it could have been hella bad for JYP. Rekka Esports were actually getting a lot of kills already, but again, like I said, Ayman's the, well, so to speak, the man for that round.
He is a man. What you want to say?
No, he's the man.
The man. And he is a man. But, Celeste with a quick pick there onto Benten. Pulls out the Deagle. Gonna try to take down a couple people, but it's not gonna happen. Ayman, once again, goes for the kill, but it's not gonna happen. The bomb is now getting planted for Record Esports. Oh, yeah, the bomb has been planted. It's now down to a 2v2 situation. How will JYP be able to execute this retake? Cross Misty gonna get forced out there by the Molotov. They know someone is a checker. And Xcurrent goes down. JYP getting another round. It's now 15-5 in their fate. Still in favor of Record Esports, but JYP is catching up.
Wow, that's pretty scary. Record Esports almost getting the one up against JYP, but Ana as well as ACAP able to keep the dream alive. Hanging on to their knife's edge. Definitely a round that JYP would wanted to win.
Yeah.
But of course, with the bomb plant being done by Record Esports, they will be able to buy up into this one.
I mean, the thing here is the pressure is on for each one of those teams, since they will be the winner of this will be flying over to Australia to compete with the other Australian teams and the other Asian teams that will be qualified and invited for the eighth for the Zen League.
Oh, look at this, cheeky! I mean, this is an inferno. This is cash, but that's a lot of Molotovs there. Hey man, the one tap onto Rousseau. Spots two more. Great flash coming from his teammates.
It actually gets a spray down there. It's just X-Ray on his own. He goes taking down Akam. His ghost down. JYP once again taking another round. Wow, JYP is feeling the momentum here.
They're slowly climbing back up. Wow, I can't believe that, you know, at the very brink of destruction, JYP are slowly coming back.
I mean, you know, they have the... They probably, after that time, after the first half, they might have talked to each other. You know, maybe their captain boosted their morale, you know. A couple of good talking might help you from time to time. And it looks like it is helping JYP. And yeah, a couple of pretty standard plays here coming in from both teams. Ooh, Frost Missy actually takes down PZ Kids, now down to a 5v4 situation. The Record Esports finally has a man advantage. They can go ahead and go for a take and know that they will have it easier on them.
Trade off. But where will they push? If you actually see JYP here, they don't have a lot of map control at all. ACAP hears a couple of footsteps and a lot of smokes as well, but JYP are becoming from other areas of the map here. They're gonna be pushing through mid. ACAP spots out there, so the one for one trade does happen. And oh, Ayman with the backstab. They cleaned up some house. And Frost Misty already on the site, but he did lose the bomb. He has to pick it up. He has to go in for the 1v2. 1v. Yeah, 1v2.
Yeah, 1v2.
He's gonna throw out the Molotov. There's the one man out. Oh my goodness, one more clutch. 1v1 ACAP. And Frost Misty, gonna get it? No! JYP still wins the round. ACAP gonna be swinging bullets after that when his teammates falling around him like flies, but still, JYP are alive.
JYP is still in the game. Rekka Esports, they are nervous at this point. I mean, they're pretty confident at this point because they have the match point, they have the advantage, they can just play it safe, so to speak, but JYP is slowly catching up to them. This is pretty scary for Rekka Esports. This might have shaken their confidence a bit. But yeah, Rekka Esports is now resorting to two CZs and a couple of Tech-9s, and it's slowly not looking like it's going to be their game. Now down to a 4v3 situation as ACAP actually takes down Xcurrent there. Bentet is pretty low with the CZ. He's not going to be able to do much. And Ayman takes down Frost Missy. He's just down to Rousseau. He has to win this. He has to do this 1v4 clutch if he wants his team to finally take this. And he finally takes down Celeste. I think he's actually going to go for the clutch here. It's not going to forward to save, but it's not going to happen. JYP once again takes the game. 15-8.
So far away. JYP. I mean, it's still seven rounds. That's still pretty far, but right now, starting to actually come together for the Thailand team.
What do you mean Thailand team?
Oh, sorry. Malaysian.
Malaysian team. Come on.
My bad, my bad.
Get your flags together, man. Alright.
Just got a little bit confused.
Alright. It happens.
Oh, pop flash in. Onto Celeste.
But, yeah. 5v5. Couple of utilities there for Wreckit Esports. Couple of utilities there for JYP. It's a pretty even match point at this point. No one has spotted each other at this point. And they... Again, once again, Wreckit Esports is just waiting for an opening. JYP spots one.
Oh, wait, hold on. That's not aggressive. PC Kid! Goodness, that wasn't good at all for Xcure. He had the angle too, but PZ Kid shuts him down.
Peeker's advantage.
Yeah, Peeker's advantage indeed, but still, he saw already. He was anticipating it, but PZ Kid also knew where Xcure was.
And yeah, that is going to have a significant blow there on Wreckit Esports. Xcure is gone. He doesn't have the AWP. They actually lost control of a part of a map there. They don't have control over B, but they do have mid control, so they can just rotate whenever they want, and the bomb is just chilling there at middle. Everybody's playing passive here. They need to play it safe, but Wreckit Esports need to make a decision. Will they go B? Will they go A? It's actually starting to look like another fake there as Rizzo takes down Anna.
Oh, he goes my goodness. Rizzo, though, gets the kill onto A-Man. That's the one guy who's been such a thorn here for Wreckit Esports on that site. But now, they're going to be going for the rotate into the A side. Oh my gosh, Benten, and now A-Cap left into a 2v1. He spots him out through the cross, but he gets nobody just yet. But Wreckit Esports down in terms of the HP's dire straits. Still, this could have been the formula to the madness.
And it's just A-Cap on his own. Will he be going for the clutch? It's now down to a 1v1 situation. Supers is actually pretty low here. And they're just gonna play it safe. A-Cap has
the last touch!
And A-Cap, wow, gets another clutch. It's now 59.
He charges in and hoping to catch A-Cap off guard. But to no joy, to no avail. And Wreckit Esports, we're so close. I can already taste victory.
What does it taste like?
It was a metaphor, dude.
Oh, I was asking. But yeah, JYP is in the game. Wreckit is already there. They can taste the victory, but they were extremely outpowered there by A-Cap. And speaking of which, this looks like an aggressive A push here by Wreckit, and they are going down like a sack of dominoes as A-Cap and Celeste clean up shop. Celeste with the 4K, 15-10 in favor of JYP, and the pause has now been called by Wreckit Esports.
Finally, they go for the tactical pause. I think they should have done this, like, I don't know, 5 rounds ago? Man.
No, guys, this is not Liquid. This is not Hiko. Hiko's not here. Come on, guys. I meant sack of potatoes. I'm sorry.
It's the
heat of the moment. I'm sorry, guys.
Sack of dominoes, or you can just change it to they're falling like dominoes.
Because I was supposed to say they're falling like dominoes and they're falling down like a sack of potatoes. They mixed in my mind, and I'm sorry. It's just that the game is so intense, my mind cannot comprehend.
Your mind can comprehend French fries or like potato-based food.
Now you're making me hungry. God damn, man. I'm hungry. No, we are not biased. We're just looking at
what's happening right now. Wreckit Esports you saw already. Like the first half, it was all them. What, 13-2, but JYP coming back. I mean, you can't deny the fact that Wreckit Esports are now the ones who are having difficult time to actually, finish out this map. And I mean, a while ago I was just saying, you know what, they're gonna win this one. They're just gonna give a couple of rounds to JYP on their CT side, but my
Smoke, Rizzo, what are you doing?
I think that smoke was not perfect at mid.
Yeah,
there was a little bit of a gap on the right side, but again, now it's a legit chance for JYP to actually come back from this one.
But don't speak too soon. It's quickly down to a 4v3 situation. Liquid
JYP is actually pretty scattered here. And the bomb is actually looking to go to A. And JYP is just less on his own in a 1v4 situation. Will he be able to clutch this? Rekka Esports significantly has a mana advantage. They have control of the side. They don't know where Celeste is. Well, they know because Celeste keeps on firing. And the bomb is now going down for Rekka Esports. And it's just Celeste with 20 bullets, 4 guys. The Molotov's gonna delay him significantly. Never mind, the smoke was there.
Well, the dream is still alive. Can he hold on to it? Or will they wake up and lose game one? That's the question here. He spots the one. Great initial kill, but still 3 members are blocking his pathway. And that's going to be Rekka Esports 16-10 winning cash.
That is game one for you, ladies and gentlemen. And yes, our next map will be...
Rain.
And this is picked by JYP, so things might be different this time around. But yeah, that was a wonderful performance coming in from JYP.